Of that, guys, having to flip at the midfield, seniors tonight, non-region game, Fultondale, one of the top-ranked 2A schools in the state, and game five. Usually game five is a non-region game for most Alabama high schools. Fultondale comes in with a record of 2-2, two close losses. Have a lot of talented players. As a matter of fact, Brother Young, they got a young man on their team by the name of Ardarius Stewart, who is a University of Alabama signee. In this day and time, the University of Alabama picks good football players.
Yes, they do. They don't go for the bottom of the barrel. And the way he was warming up, he looks like he's going to be a good one for the Crimson Tide.
Patriot defense will have to do an outstanding job, take some angles on this guy. As Coach Causey said in the paper today, there is speed, and then there's that special speed and quickness. And Mr. Stewart has that. So we've got our work cut out for us. We can contain him just a little bit. This will be a great game for us.
We'll have to be on our toes, that's for sure, and make sure we do stay at home on the outsides and contain him, not let him get outside and break one for a long run.
Waiting on the Patriots to take the field. Fultondale's getting ready to break through their little barrier over there. Here come the Patriots. Record of 3-1. One of six home games this year. We don't even go out of the county until Fayette County. So we're enjoying this night. Not quite cool enough for me, Darrell, but hey, it's a lot better than it was that first couple of games.
That's for sure. It was warm. I think by the halftime, we'll be quite comfortable.
Team's about getting ready to go out on the field. Patriots getting their last instructions. Coach is ready. Got the earphones on. Chuck Carr is back with us on the field, looks like, tonight. Came back Holt game. Great game for us over at Holt. This will be a great, great game if we can pull this one off going into back into region next week with the Gordo Green Wave coming to town. ACA is going to kick. Connor Thigpen getting that ball ready. And I can tell you this right now, Darrell, I can tell you who we don't want to kick it to, and he's going back there.
Well, the way Connor's setting up, it looks like he's going to kick him short like he did our last home game. Not going to even tempt him. I'll tell you, he's got a leg to put it in the end zone, but if you can keep it away from trouble, sometimes that's not a bad move.
You're right about that. I tell you what, this Fultondale bunch looks very athletic. Very athletic. Guys, game number five about underway. It is. He does kick it to the corner. Guy bobbles the ball.
Ball's on the ground. We were real close to picking one up.
That was tremendous effort by the ACA Patriots. Almost came away with a fumble on the kickoff, which would have been absolutely huge. Fultondale lines up, not getting in the huddle. Overloaded to the right. And number two is looked like taking the snap. Where is that number 13?
He's down here on the bottom field, lined up as wide out.
And they're getting it right to him.
Oh, he was breaking those tackles. Sure got to wrap up.
Went for a first down, about 14 yards. Very quick. But I tell you what, young Bradford did a good job on hanging on until the rest of the Patriots got there. They move him all over the place. Back in the shotgun. Number two gets the ball, goes to him again.
Oh.
And then coaches are hollering holding, but no flags on the play that I see.
There was some holding going on over there. I don't know why it wasn't called. He was right there at it, looking at it.
We've seen a little bit of that this year heading the draft.
We have quite a bit.
I'm not Let's see here. Number two still at the quarterback position. He's faking it to him. He's going to go long. Number 12, overthrown.
Good coverage.
Great
by Parker
coverage.
There right
great
there.
Great coverage.
On yep. him step for step.
They faked to Mr. Stewart out here to draw our attention. And you can see that was a well-designed play. When they go to him almost every play already till that play. So
brings up third and seven. Time for our defense to step up. Get the ball back.
Be a great three and out right here if we can hold them here. Shotgun. Mr. Stewart is in the shotgun. He's going to take it. And looks like he has the first down.
Gave him a generous spot right at the 50-yard line.
First and 10 midfield. No big play yet, but you can tell they're just a step or two away. Defense doing a good job. There is Stewart under center, two in the backfield, two wide out.
Hand off tackle.
Loss.
Doing.
I may have a loss of 1 or 2 yards there.
There was nowhere to go.
Great play. Great defensive play there.
Second and 11.
We're going to need a couple of big plays. Be tremendous to get that ball back without them scoring. Overloaded to the left side. Stewart getting that ball again. He's going to run it. Got to take an angle on him. They get away. He's out of bounds.
Play.
Screaming and holding. Our coaches are. But did we get a flag? Was that a flag?
Yeah,
on
there
the
is a flag right there on the five of the 50-yard line. It is a holding against Fultondale.
Big time penalty for us. That helped.
Back them up. Bring up second and 20.
That's going to help us there. Most people, I would say, on that play, we would string it out and they wouldn't get very many yards. But number 13 is very, very fast.
He is quick.
Defense doing a good job, though.
On the offense, a 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
This is going to be a good game. Second 19, 41-yard line on Fultondale's 41. They got trips out right on top of your screen. Single guy down here. He's going and rolling out right. It's holding again, but they're not calling it. Intercepted.
That was a great play.
He returns it to their 34-yard line. Big time play by number 47. Somebody got our rosters, and you'll all have to forgive us tonight. We're going to try to get that so we can call some names. So we need to get a roster with the names of the players. Mr. Crow was in here. Coach Crow, he'd probably have all that done.
He'd have it all lined out for us. He is missed.
And if you're listening, Greg, checking up on us, sorry about that. Mullen Brock under center. Two men in the backfield. Going to throw the ball right out.
Just a little bit high for Aaron Box.
In the flat. Came out chunking that ball, man. I tell you what. Again, mentioned it before, athletic. Fultondale has good-looking team, very athletic in every position. Good size on the line. Cornerback, safety. Of course, Mr. Stewart's playing safety, so it's going to be hard to outrun that rascal, but hey. Looks like we're going to do a little power football here. Mullenbrock takes it. Austin Aiken has the ball. He's going to have about, well, he's still running. I was going to say he's going to have about 1 or 2 yards, but I think he got about three.
Yeah, it looks like a gain of three and a half. Bring up third and seven.
Okay. We need another first down to be in field goal range, but – man, if we can get close, we might go for it. Coach might go for it here.
This very well could be four down territory. Punt's not going to gain you a whole lot.
That's exactly right. Ball on 32, third, about seven. All good seven. Austin in the gun. Austin Aiken behind him. Trips to the right. He's trying to look the spray safety off. Got John Roberts. Oh, had him open. Had him open, had him and the ball got there a little too quick for John. Don't know if that was miscommunication on them or not, but the play was there. Looks like we're going to go for it, Drill.
Yep. Time to man up. Make a good throw, make a good catch.
Be interested to see what this play is. Fourth and seven. Pretty tough situation to call. Pretty sure we'll throw it, but who knows? Parker Dare's got man coverage out here. I might give him a shot. He's faking it, back, got plenty of time. He throws it and is overthrown his receiver again. He was there.
He was open.
Don't know if he'd had a first down.
I don't think he
close.
Would have. I think he would have been a couple yards short, but
just a little bit, we're just a little bit too far out and above our targets tonight.
Yep.
So both teams don't score on the first possessions. Fultondale has the ball. Stewart
dive
hands
up
off.
The middle.
Oh, great.
Not much to it.
Maybe a yard. Hey, if Mr. Dare Stewart doesn't carry the ball so far, we've done a great job. And we got somebody down.
Looks like number 75, Austin Holloman, down on the ground.
That's who it is.
That's one you don't want to lose. Our center on offense.
That's
a really
not,
good defensive
that's
line.
That's not going to be good. Got a timeout.
8:24 left to go in the first quarter.
Austin's still down, and he's not moving a whole lot.
Looks like Darrell, that's working on his left leg.
That's going to be, if he can't come back, I don't know who our second string center is, but he needs to be getting some reps right now with Austin Mullenbrock. And that might be, I just saw Chris Smelly kind of pat number 72, Mr. Brown, on the shoulder like, hey, get ready. You may be the – Nelson Brown may be our next center. He's up and walking.
Maybe it'll be something that he can walk out. Not quite coming off under his own power. Hope is nothing that's too serious. Play resumes. We've got second down, 8 yards to go for Fultondale.
All right.
And in motion, handed to him around the side.
Speed sweep.
And he found a hole. And it closed up, but he's able to pick up about 7 yards, bring up third and 1.5.
I tell you, speed is just hard to deal with, and that's what they have at every position. Darius Stewart just has a little more of it than everybody else. Third and one.
Nelson Brown with the tackle. Third and short, 2.
They have.
I would look for that quarterback draw again on third and short, too.
Exactly what I'd look for. You've got it spread out, two receivers each side of the field. That's exactly,
here it comes.
That's
and they
exactly,
stop
great,
it.
Great.
They stop it.
You see where that spot is.
He picked up one, but didn't pick up the one and a half that he had to have.
No, sir. It's fourth down. I'd look for maybe the same play again. Number 12 is the quarterback. No, Stewart's on the center. I'm sorry. Stewart's on the center. It's going to be a quarterback sneak, I bet you. That's what they think it's going to be. They're trying to change the play. They're rushing in to punt. 17
here comes
seconds
the punt team.
On the, trying to get them off field. One, two, three. And we got enough people. Stay. Great discipline by our defense.
Oh, ball's on the ground. Can we block it? No.
He got the kickoff. It's going to be a roll it down to about the 26 or 7 yard line. Good job, defense. Very disciplined there, Darrell, on that series. Very disciplined on that series. Great hold for the Patriots. Yeah, it looks like Nelson Brown's in at center. We need to be very careful here with him being in there because of the injury to Austin Holloman. Make sure we're going to get that snap. And Austin Mullenbrock is going under center, which is probably smart. You don't want to long snap that thing with a new center in there right off the bat.
No. They've got
Mullenbrock under center. John Roberts down out left. Box in motion. We're going to run the football.
Yep.
Great run.
Good hard running by.
Picked up about 5 yards. Little extracurricular going on.
That's not a bad run with 8 in the box.
That's a great first down game. Got a good 5, maybe even 6. So we can open up the playbook a little bit. Looks like we're going to shotgun this time. John Roberts single coverage. He's out there by himself. This might be a good shot here. Mr. Stewart's not even looking over there, but he can get there. Box in motion to the left. Oh, my. That's what we didn't want.
Nowhere to go.
Lost what we gained and maybe a little more.
Looks like lost 7
on
that.
And, guys, that's something, you know, Darrell, you got a new center and you're long snapping it. That's just tough. It's just tough. Nelson's
really
going to have to get used to that. I don't really see Austin Hall. He's still sitting there. That hurt, guys. That hurt. 3rd and 11. Had a good opportunity there. Tough snap. Tough situation. We're gonna long snap it again in the gun. We got a speed rush from Mr. Stewart over here on the left side.
Draw up the middle.
Get up there. Made a good run. Got back the 5 yards we lost, the 5 of the 6, but looks like we're going to have to punt. Tough deal, but hey, good team we're playing. 4:40 left in the first. No score. Guess who's going back for Fultondale to get the punt? So I hope, and I'm pretty sure, Mr. Thigpen will put it over here close to us. Oh, he kicked it to him.
Right.
It's kind of cool to side. Oh, he's going to pick it up on the
he
run.
Picked it up.
Surround him. And we did. Great coverage.
That was good coverage.
Great
we had
coverage.
Absolutely nowhere to go.
We had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 guys around him.
Dropped him right at the 31-yard line. So that was good coverage.
Even if you're going to the University of Alabama, you're a good athlete. It's hard to outrun 6 guys all around. All right, Darrell, we're back on defense. They've done a great job defensively. Just tremendous holding.
They
this.
Have. Fultondale's picked up 1 first down. Hadn't done much other than that.
No, and they've scored a bunch of points on some folks, some good teams. So they've got double receivers on either side of the ball. They're trying to spread us out, but we're really playing it close to the
zone
basket.
Read.
Zone
oh,
read.
Oh, that's more holding.
Great deal. He's still got a few yards, but great defense.
Brody Kale almost had him in the backfield. Looks like somebody's holding a little bit of that jersey.
Saw a little jersey pop there, doing a good job.
Second and seven at the 33.
All right, Mr. Stewart takes a snap. He's going long. He throws that deep. Ball. And he overthrew the guy. But he was there. We need to make sure we have that covered. What can he not do?
Hey, as far as he threw that ball, I think he was the only one that could have caught it.
Probably so. He threw it about 40 in the air, kind of off his back foot. That makes it third and about seven for the Wildcats from Fultondale. White jerseys and orange helmet trimmed in black. So here we go again. We're going to blitz a little bit. Don't let him outside. We got holding on 77. The guy had the ball. He came up. They're going to punt. Big time defense again. Coach Stafford's done a great job preparing these guys, doing a great job. And I'm going to tell you, Darrell, that's about the fifth hole I've seen. Number 64, Logan Elliott, was trying to go lateral, and the jersey was kept popping off twice. Somebody holding him. So we're going to get the ball back again, see if we can't get on the scoreboard. Wolfendale punting formation.
They're coming after
they
this
sure
one.
Are.
Oh, they almost got
they
it.
They almost did.
So he's Parker on an island back there by himself. I'm glad he didn't pick that ball up.
He almost picked it up.
He thought about it.
He didn't want to take the chance.
Looks up and sees.
Great decision.
Five wrong color jerseys running at him. So.
He saw what Darius Stewart saw the last punt he got. So he said, I'm not going to try this. All right. ACA gets the ball again here in the first quarter. About 3 minutes to go. No score. Ball on the 23. John Roberts in the slot. Parker Dare in the backfield. They got a bunch of guys in the box. They're daring us to throw the football. And we're going for it. Parker Dare.
Quick swing pass, Parker. Oh,
he
slips and
down.
Lost his foot.
Oh, man. And he had at least a few more yards. He had a few more yards to get, and he got still got about five, four, three, about three. So we're going to open it up a little bit. Got to. I think everybody's in the box except number 13, free
they
safety.
Are. They've got eight in the box, a couple corners, but.
I like John Roberts by himself, but we haven't gotten that yet. All right, we got a guy in the slot on the right side. John's one-on-one up there on the top on the left, so we'll see what happens. We're going to run this football this time. Here goes Parker Dare. He's got some room.
Picks up the first down, gains about 10.
Great run. Good play calling from our coaches. Coach Smelly. Doing a good job calling those plays, taking what they give us, working the edges with all those in the box. First down. Full moon, beautiful night, not too hot. Going to get real cool next week. Got a timeout on the field. I don't know if it's a...
ACA call timeout.
Call timeout.
2:05 left to go in the first. All knotted up at zero.
We got a new cameraman in the booth, Mr. Cole Finley, doing a great job. Just got recruited today. On the computer doing Greg Crow's job, John Galbraith, he's doing a good job too. Felt like myself, you know, when you're my age, you can't figure this stuff out. Got John up here, and he had her done. I was trying to get a hold of Coach Crow. He's up in Nashville. Don't know if he's recording up there or not. Anyway, John Galbraith did a good job getting us online, getting us streaming live. Cole Finley's up here doing the camera, so we appreciate these guys helping us out. First down ACA, 36-yard line. Maybe we can get something going. I still like John Roberts. They got him man-to-man with number 11. Looks like a good athlete. They're going to give him a lot of attention, as they should. Nelson Brown starting to kind of get it down. Nelson always adapts well. He's just that kind of kid. Here we go. We've got a speed sweep.
And nowhere to go.
Nowhere to go.
He found a little bit of a hole.
Got a little bit back. I'm going to tell you a little misdirection on that. That
would have been a good one. They are shifting awfully quick when they see a man in motion.
They sure are, and they're coming to the ball real fast. So don't be surprised a little bit later if we don't have a little misdirection. We get something going, Darrell, and then we have us a play that gets us in a hole. So it's second and 13. Need to make a little bit back on this, so we have a shot at a first down. Austin Mullen brought in the gun. Parker there behind him, tailback. He looks off the free safety, throws it to Parker. He's trying to get up, and he slips again. That's the second time Parker's had several yards more left, and he slips down.
Got a man down for Fultondale, number 33.
4 yard gain on the play by Parker there.
On his leg, it looks like, down at the 25-yard line.
Official timeout on the field.
Another timeout. Fultondale man down. I tell you what, I want to take this time right now to ask, if you're listening live, if we stream out live, call the school if you can think about it. Either tonight, tomorrow. We'll give you a number in just a second and an extension. And let us know maybe who you are and that you're listening and where you're from, where you're listening from. We may have somebody not in Tuscaloosa or somebody in another state. My son was listening from San Jose, Costa Rica last week. He may be listening now. I don't know. But you can call 205-553-5963, punch in extension 27, and just tell us who you are and that you were listening live. And we'll take a little criticism if we need to, won't we, Darrell?
All day long.
Make it better. I'll give out that number again in just a minute. We got third and 10. Austin back in the gun. Nelson Brown, the new center. Austin takes the snap, looking downfield.
Coverage,
got a man open.
Got John Roberts.
Perfect. First down.
Right at the sticks.
Number four is giving him so much cushion that can work just about every time. Great play. Great call. Great route. Great pass.
Tell you, John knew exactly where he needed to go for the first down, and he went right there.
Perfect. Perfect. That number again is 205-553-5963, extension 27. Get the voicemail of Miss Tina Terry, who's the athletic secretary. Just leave a message, and I'll tell her that you're going to call this weekend. We'll get that out again a little bit later. First down, Austin back in the gun. Austin Aikens behind him. Cody Crell in motion, doing a little trap. Somebody missed the block. Number 50, what's that boy?
52.
He's a big old fella now. He moves very, very well. How big is that guy?
Darius Lawrence, 5'11", 289. He is a big fella.
And he moves pretty well for 289.
You
got to hit that hole pretty hard, but he was there. Is this another?
I think it's going to be the end of the first quarter running out.
All right. No score. First quarter's done in the books. Fultondale, American Christian Academy, non-region game, week 5. Great, great ball game so far. Somebody's waiting for somebody else to blink. And we don't need to be the one doing the blinking. So, anyway, I think we're going to have a little extra halftime entertainment tonight for those that are listening. We always try to show the visiting band and our band, but I think we've had a big week of young cheerleader training. I think first grader K through 6 is going to be performing at halftime, if I'm not mistaken. I believe that's happening tonight. if I'm wrong, I'll have to apologize, but I think that's going to happen, so that'll be interesting. Always good to see.
That'll be fun, both for the kids and for parents,
no
grandparents.
Doubt. A lot of pictures to be taken, no doubt. Probably got more grandparents just because of that in the stands. All right, about to start the second quarter. Back in the gun, got two running backs. J.D. Heist, Austin Aiken, either side, Mr. Mullenbrock. Mr. Box is out here by himself. Let's see what happens. We're going to throw that thing. In the flat, he reads it good.
That.
Yeah,
there
we
comes
got a flag.
That flag.
That was a little late hit.
That was
unprotected
very late.
Hit. Man in the flat, ball was overthrown. Very tough throw to make. Guy comes up pretty good bit after the game was over. I mean, the play was over with. And puts the hammer down.
It's 15 yards, but I tell you, we would have rather had that 15 yards other than getting a personal foul like that. He's going to feel that one.
No doubt. Was that Parker Dare that got hammered? No, it was Austin Aiken.
No, it was Austin Aiken.
So Parker Dare comes in for him. That back out of the flat, Austin Mullenbrock had read it perfectly. He looked the guys off, took what they gave him, just had it out there just a little bit too high for him. One of the hardest passes to make out of the backfield for a quarterback is about swinging out of the back.
Yeah, you've got to lead him just right. Otherwise, that play happens just like we just had, a little bit behind him.
But, hey, we're in Fultondale territory on their 37-yard line, 38-yard line. Same formation, just flipped a little bit. Oh, Parker Dare, he's out there by himself. We're going to run the football.
Awesome.
And I'm going to tell you, maybe why we're throwing it a lot, because we're having trouble blocking the front seven, Fultondale. They're quick, athletic, pretty good size.
They're coming off the ball quick indeed. There was a hole for a split second for Aaron Box, but it closed up before he could get through it.
Caleb Squires checks in. Along with number nine, Newman Bailey, Parker Dare in motion. I tell you what, hit him in the seam. Oh, great catch!
Great catch by Parker Dare. He went down next to the grass and scooped that thing right
and
up.
And I'll tell you something there, Darrell. That was a great pass. Great play, but we're very, very lucky. The Fultondale coach is screaming at the referee over there. Parker Dare, he did take a few steps toward the line of scrimmage, and no flag was thrown. So we're very fortunate on that situation.
Well, they missed a few on our side of the ball, too.
Yeah, about three or four holdings made up for that, but Coach from Fultondale is not happy at all. So we're got the eye. Austin Mullenbrock's under center. Let's see if we try to run that football. We're going to try to power that thing.
Aaron Box around the right
gets
side.
Up there, runs hard. Great.
5, 6, 7, 8 yards. That was a good hard run.
Oh, super, super effort. I tell you what, I like that play. We just lined up and ran that thing. It's going to give us a second short, it looks like. You know, you want to be very careful here. I might take a shot in the end zone here.
Yeah, I'm thinking a shot in the end zone would be a good play.
Because they're going to pursue. You fake a handoff and pull up and hit somebody in the end zone, but you got to be careful. It's not there. You don't want to throw it. Not, you don't want to waste this situation. Connor Thigpen would be automatic from here, but we would rather have six. J.T. High should hit tailback this time. Austin Mullenbrock under center. Uh-oh.
Option play.
We had a miscommunication there. Backs went different ways. Austin turned. Nobody was there. But, hey, I think he might have got the first down. Well, it's going to be close.
They're going to call for a measurement.
Timeout for the refs. They're going to call a measurement. Hey, we'll take it. We'll take it.
It's going to be real close. If he got it, he got it just by the nose of the ball.
For a minute there, I thought he was going to make a pitch. And I don't think that was the play call. So Austin did the safest thing, which is what the quarterback should do. Man, he pitches that ball to the tailback.
Looks like he's short by the length of a football.
Well, we got to hammer it twice and get that football over that 7-yard line. We may run that play we were going to try to run just previously. I think that's a quick handoff to Aaron Box in the fullback position, because they're closing those gaps pretty quick by the time our tailback can get through the hole. So maybe Aaron can get through there before it happens. We're just about to find out right now.
They've got 9 guys up in the box on this play.
Wow. Quarterback sneak.
He's got it.
Oh, big Nelson Brown is still pushing him, guys.
They pushed that pile down the field 3-4 yards, got down real close to the 5-yard line.
We needed to get to the 7, but big Nelson just kept on digging, and we got down to 5, right on the 5. First and 5, first and goal. Patriots in business. 9 minutes to go in the second quarter. Big time drive. John Roberts out to the left side. Parker there up top. Man, they got everybody in there. Oh, great pass.
Oh, Aaron,
beautiful play.
Himself in the end zone. Nobody.
Not
coming out.
Man, they thought we were going to hand that ball off. They had everybody up on the line. Wonderful play call, Coach Smelly. Wonderful
touchdown
play call.
Touchdown ACA. 8:51 to go in the first.
Big time. Big time. That's what we needed, guys. That's what we needed.
Connor Thigpen on. Add on the extra.
Somebody, we're missing somebody on the field. We got plenty of time. Aaron Kirkley runs out there. Whether he's supposed to be out there or not, he took the spot.
I think it may be because we got Austin Hallman.
And that's what it
on
is.
On the sideline.
Somebody's bad snap. He still kicks it. And it is no good.
No good. Just barely missed it.
Well, here again, but we needed that point. This game can be close, and we need every point we can get.
Hey, I would take this opportunity to practice some of those snaps.
No doubt. No doubt. I was going to say that Nelson Brown, you know, being new still, but I don't think he snapped it. I think Aaron Box is a regular snapper, and he just didn't get that back there. So, anyway, we'll take that 6. Glad to get it. We get the ball in the second half. It's always good if you go in, I think, go in halftime with a lead. You get the ball in the second half. But, hey, man, there's 9 minutes to go. And we've been fortunate so far to keep Mr. Football last year in 2A. Darren Stewart in check. That could change at any moment. So maybe we can continue our tremendous, tremendous defensive effort.
They saw where we kicked it last time, and they put him right there.
Oh, they're trying to get him that ball. Now they're swapping again. Fake them off there, Connor. Just kick it over his head. And he kicks it beautifully. In the corner. It's live. The guy picks it up on the 5.
Got a block
in the
back.
That's a block in the back. You've got
to cannot believe. Oh, the ball's on the ground. ACA's got it. ACA has the ball on the 3-yard line.
And can you believe? And I'm glad we got the ball.
I think somebody saw it and threw the flag. Or may just thrown a beanbag for the fumble. But I cannot believe you would not call that block in the back.
Now, there was 2 umpires there, and the guy was all by himself and just hammered one of our guys in the back. But hey, we'll take the ball. We'll take the ball. Big play. Big play. We're back on the 5.
Let's just run that same play we ran last time we were on the 5.
Of course, it may be so soon they're not looking for it.
That's
great point. Great point, Darrell. Great point. In the gun. Great.
There it is. John Roberts for a touchdown.
1-on-1. Got number 11 to his back. Played him just like a rebound. Got him on his backside. Perfect throw. Great catch. The Patriots, as Gary Harris says on his show, and I'll steal from it, we have a reservation for 6 in the end zone.
There you go.
So maybe we get that snap right here, make this thing 13-0. Great situation for the ACA Patriots.
Great way to capitalize on a mistake made by Fultondale. Snaps better
good.
This time.
Now you know
everything. It's up and good.
Good job. Well, we love it when it goes our way, don't we? Super. Great, great effort. Now,
37 left to go in the first. Bring up 13-0 Patriots.
Interesting to see if they do the same shifting around, Darrell. You can't help but think that all the shifting that Fultondale was trying to do to get Darius Stewart the ball kind of added to the fumble, because the guy picked the ball up from the ground on their five. Might have had a chance to roll out of bounds, but you never know. He took the ball. Connor Thickbend did a super, super job, and the guy fumbled. So we'll be interested to see how it goes now.
Yeah, they outsmarted themselves on that one.
They sure did. We got, they line up like they usually do right now. Connor's looking down there. I'm sure he's seeing where number 13 is. And he goes back to the same spot, up high. The guy comes up to get it. Number 12 gets the ball.
Oh, great stop, ball on the ground again. Oh, they whistled it
dead. They whistled it dead, and it was probably because it hit the turf. But who was that?
Got the white hat throwing the beanbag flag, and you got another man over on the side whistling it dead.
Do we have the replacement refs tonight?
I'm wondering if we got some replacement refs going on over here.
Hey, I think that was J.T. Heiss that made that shoestring tackle. That was a great effort by J.T. Heiss.
It was. He reached out there and knocked those
legs.
Got
that foot, and it almost caused another fumble. Mr. Stewart's getting the ball in the gun. He's going to try to take his ball over with, this game over with. Good tackle. Dude gets about 5 yards, but you know, we give up 5 yards. He gets it most of the time. We'll only be able to make a break for the end zone. 8 minutes to go in the second quarter. ACA defense.
Looks like Fultondale's going with a no huddle.
Doing a super job.
Two men in the backfield, William Samuel Brown, number 9, and Kyrie Robinson, number 12.
Well, they started a little early, too.
Hand off number 9. Not much doing.
Great job, but he drove us back about 3 yards. It's been great to hold him to about 3rd and 5, but it's going to be 3rd, about 2, it looks like. Depends on the spot.
Generous
about
spot.
1, very generous spot. 3rd and 1. I'd be willing to take a bet who just runs for this first down and tries to.
I'll give you 3 guesses. The first 2 don't count.
He's under center.
31 to 36. Oh, he hands it off.
Oh, almost. He got the first down, but I'm going to tell you, folks, it was just by just barely a yard because he was met in the hole.
And Brody Kale met him, stood him up for a second, but didn't have the legs moving far hard enough to push him back.
I'll tell you what, Sean Black was in on that too. I'm going to tell you, our defense is really, really playing well. They got a first down, but we're making them work. So far, not giving up the big play. We're making them work for it. Stewart in the shotgun again. Trips out here. He rolls out toward the trip side. He's throwing back across the field.
Look at deep down the middle. He's got a man.
He got a man. Oh, beautiful. Defense. Had a man for a second. But,
great
but I'm going to tell you now.
Number 14, Colton Bradford.
Colton Bradford closed, slapped the ball at the perfect moment. Nick Saban would have been proud.
That was perfect timing. Any sooner would have been pass interference, but he was right there with the ball.
That was, I'm going to tell you what, he's been pretty, pretty consistent all year.
Yes, he
Colton
has.
Bradford.
Spreading us out again. Got double wides.
Got double wides, and we're not giving a lot of attention to anybody but the man.
Running the option.
He pitched
the man.
We got
like
it covered. Great.
Ball
again.
On the ground. Looks like it was recovered by Fultondale. Picked up 2 yards right at the 40-yard.
I tell you what, Darrell, we had that thing covered up, and we almost had the ball again. Great defensive effort. Great defensive effort. I don't know who that was that put the tackle on Mr. Stewart, but did a great job making him pitch the ball. 3rd and 8. Big play.
He's keeping the quarterback keeper. He's got we had him.
We had him and let him get away. Had him locked up and let him get away. First down.
10 on the play out to the ACA 49-yard line.
I hate we missed that opportunity, Darrell. We had to
stop in the backfield. Let him go.
6 minutes to go. Fultondale driving, first down on ACA 49-yard line. Trips out to the right. The Deuce up top, spreading it out for us. We're going to try to see if we can keep him hemmed up. He looks over, they're calling the play from the sideline. Be careful, we got man-to-man all over the field. I hope we can stay with him. Did he catch
it? I don't think he caught that. They said he did.
That was a great catch. He had to dive back. Number two had to dive back for Fultondale. Christopher
Lewis.
Good
back shoulder pass.
Super, super throw. You got to give that to him. They're trying to get something going. They know they need to score before halftime. Again, they have Deuces both sides, man in the backfield. Stewart takes the ball, hands it off. Big Nelson Brown says,
right there,
you're not going anywhere else.
Very short game, but it looks like it might be enough to pick up the first down.
Yep. Very well. Not giving up the big play so far. That's saying a lot when you have the weapons Fultondale has. Man-to-man on the outside. A lot of folks in the box. They're going to run it. Oh, good. Two hits, and he still gets about 14 yards.
We had him met. They had number two, Christopher Lewis, playing quarterback, handing it off to number 13, Ardarius Stewart.
He ran through two tackles, finally got him down.
Got to wrap up.
They are definitely putting the load on number 13. And he's got his hands on his hips, so maybe he'll be too tired to do too much. But he's
number
the man.
27 from ACA, Cole Campbell put that hit on him. He had to come off. Looks like it rung his bell.
Number two back quarterback, Fultondale, and here they go again.
I tell you, when number two is playing quarterback, you got 13 in the backfield, I wouldn't key anywhere else.
Nowhere else. And he just outruns us to the left side. Got to take an angle on that guy or he will not win the race with number 13.
Definitely got to turn him back inside.
4 minutes to go in half. Fultondale driving, threatening to score on ACA's 19, second and five. Here they go again. Usually he sprints out this way when they have trips out to the right. Guy in the slot, top to the left. Hope he's tired, you ask us.
Oh.
What was that? Our coaches were clapping at something. They blow the whistle.
It might have been a timeout. I don't see a flag on the play. Timeout ACA.
Timeout ACA. Probably not a bad call. Seeing what they're going to run. I don't know if they'll run it again. Just under 4 minutes to go. I'm going to tell you, Fultondale has not scored yet in this game. And quite frankly, with the weapons they have, if you would have told me that before the game started, I would have said the chances were slim and none, and Slim would be out of town. But I want to tell you, ACA defense has come to play.
They have
no big plays. I mean, probably the largest gain that they've had. Mr. Stewart's got most of them, 10, 15 yards on several occasions. But other than that, they have not let him burn them or get behind them. Great plays in the secondary. Good coaching plan.
We've had him stopped on several of those long carries and just failed to wrap up and shut it down.
That's exactly right.
We've been in the right place. We just got to
make the play.
First tackle.
Got to make the play. But, tell you what, let's see what they label this Tim as. 6'1", 181. He's every bit of that. And very strong. Again, we have trips out to the right. like they had before. Let's see if they look like they're going the same play. He's striking back. He's going to go deep. Colton Bradford, great play
again.
I'm going to tell you, number 14, so far, he's a player of the game.
He has knocked down two passes. It could have been six.
I'm telling you, number two is a good-looking athlete, and I know he's got speed, but he is – Mr. Bradford is just doing an outstanding job running with his man, looking back to the ball just like you're supposed to and knocking it down. Third and five, same lineup they had before. Mr. Stewart fakes
right up
it.
Up the middle.
He gets the first down. Hard to stop, Darrell.
Yeah, well, I think we bid on that fake in around. Uh-oh, Parker Dare's down.
That's not good.
He's holding his head.
That's not good. Official timeout. Second quarter, 3:33 left in the half. Fultondale looks like they're on about the 10. And we're looking at Parker Dare down on the 15-yard line right in the middle of the field. And he's in pain, it looks like, from here. Austin Akins went out a while ago. He comes out on the field to check on his friend, bringing some water. I hope he's ready to go. He's up on his feet.
The injured player for American Christian, number one, Parker Dare.
Can't tell what happened, Darrell, but
no. Looks like he's still feeling a little wobbly.
Well, I've got an idea what happened. But I'm not going to say it on air.
No.
Those that are watching, I don't know if we got that cold on camera, but we'll just hope Parker has it. He needs a little time to gather himself. I think they look like they're going to start to play, and Parker's not off the field yet. Need to get him some fluids and try to stop Fultondale. Number 13, you know he's going to carry the ball. I'd be surprised if I was Fultondale coach, let anybody else touch the ball right here. So he's in the backfield by himself, gets the ball. He's going to throw it.
He's going to run. Quarterback draw.
And he scores. Very easy. You got to know that's going to happen. So ACA defense finally gives up six, but I'm going to tell you, they played a heck of a game.
They have. But he did a great job selling that draw.
And I'm going to tell you, he's tired. He basically carried them down the field. He's a guy that can do that. But I tell you what, he's tired. They go for the point after, kick the ball. It is good. So we got a 13-7 game. We've got 3 minutes left, 3 minutes, 18 seconds left in the half. Hey, if we can get down here and score again, it'd be great, or get close enough to let Mr. Thickpin use that super leg he's got.
Parker Dare out. Don't know who we're going to put back to return this kick.
Well, like we had a rush in on the point after a while ago, we've got to know who's out, who's got the place you got to take. It should be a little easier to do on the kickoff. This will be the first kickoff reception of the game for ACA. Looks like JT Heiss is going back. John Roberts. Looks like John Roberts is going to be the man. Sure hands. Beautiful night, full moon. 3:18 to go at Patriot Field. Fair crowd from Fultondale. They did bring their band. We're about to kick off to the Patriots and see if we can get back on the scoreboard a little bit, because we will get the ball in the second half, which is always good. Here's the kickoff. Oh, man, let that go.
Get up right at the sideline. He's let that go.
Great. Out of the sideline.
No time off the clock. Put the ball at the.
That'll be a great, great setup for us. ball at the 35. Hey, the ball, did it make it to the 35?
I think it went right out at the 34-yard line.
First down, Patriot, at the 35.
3:18 left to go in the first half. See if ACA can draw something up to move it down the field.
John Roberts and Newligan Bailey in the slot on the right side. Aaron Box swapping over to that side. Charlie Thickpin over here, one-on-one, number 11. Charlie jumped. So he's new in the game. Young guy, really tough when you come in like that. We'll have five more yards to go. Ninth grader didn't probably get a whole lot of playing time. He's going to be a great, got good athletic skills. But we've got to cover some ground here.
Oh, they're calling all sides on the defense.
Well, I'll be.
We will take that.
Didn't see that, but no. We'll take it. Maybe the reason Charlie was moving around, the guy was over there on his side of the ball.
That very well could be.
Number 11 has been burnt tonight, so he's a little nervous. Charlie's up on the line. Yep. Here we go. On the rock, back in the gun. The ball. I tell you, we're not getting on somebody. I don't know who it is.
Number 22.
He was unblocked, it looked like.
I don't think anybody touched him. Julian Hardy. Senior linebacker. I don't think we put a hand on him.
He must have blitzed through. They have, like I mentioned before, great athletes, good speed. He was there quickly. We're not getting to the hole. Got eight in the box. We're going to go for the sweep.
Block it if he can get around it. Oh,
I'm going to tell you now.
That was a big hit, but I mean, it was a
Parker is hurt.
Head-to-head hit.
Parker's hurt, and Mr. Stewart just absolutely. We got the first down, though.
That should have been a penalty, though. I mean, he went right at helmet. Helmet-to-helmet contact like that, that should have been another 15-yard penalty on the end of that run.
The injured player for American Christian, number 23, Austin
Aiden. Mr. Stewart is just taking the game over. He made a hit then that was unbelievable. Could be on the replays. But Austin popped right up. He's probably going to have to stay out at least a play. I'll tell you what, Darrell, the way Adair Stewart is coming up, he is leaving that center field wide open. Something that might be exploited down the road if we've got a pitchback pass or something of that nature. Got first down. 2:37 to go. Trying to get down the field at least in field goal range. We've got enough time. Don't make any mistakes. We might be able to get a score before halftime. Here we go. First and 10, ball on the eight.
Gain of two on the play. But
I like that quick handoff to the fullback. That might work if we can get some ISO blocks. Because they are closing the gaps so fast. Austin back in the gun. Aaron Bach behind him.
Late hit out of bounds. That needs to be another flag.
That should be a flag, big time, and I don't see one thrown. The referee,
I don't know how that could not be a flag. He was 3 yards out of bounds when that hit came.
You seen he caught the ball?
He did catch the ball, but he was hit out of bounds.
Ooh-wee. I don't know what that guy was thinking about over there, but John Roberts caught the ball for about a 6-yard gain. Went out of bounds, and he was well out of bounds. And Mr. Ian Tinsley, Fultondale, just clobbered. blitzing. Get rid of that football.
Oh, that would have been a good time to look down the field.
Well,
loss of one on the catch.
We're not making that block. The linebacker's coming up, and we're not getting a block on him, or that would have been a first down.
Fultondale calls the timeout, stops the clock, fourth down, 4 yards to go for ACA.
Tough situation. Tough situation here. You got to punt the ball. I say you got to punt the ball because you punt it toward the corner out of bounds back here as far as you can and make Fultondale go the length of the field to try to score. Timeout on the field. Fourth and five for ACA. We're expecting a punt. But who knows? We may pull a Green Bay and fake that thing. I doubt we do it at this point.
I wouldn't want to give them this short of the field with a minute 40 left to go in the half. Go ahead and see if we can pin them down deep. Hang a one out towards the sideline over there.
I see Connor Pickpin going out there. You know that's what's going to happen. All right, Mr. Thigpen. Punted a mile high or over here to the home stand. Here we go.
Punt. They've got the return on. He does. He kicks it right out towards the sideline. It's going to take a good hit.
Wow.
Oh, rolls
at
out.
The five.
At the 5 yard line. That is a great punt. Great punt.
Flag on the play, midfield.
I would have had to been holding.
Wonderful kick.
Dead ball personal foul against ACA.
Why in the world would we want somebody to get a personal foul for us? That's a very, very bad timing. Are they going to make us punt it again or do it in the spot of the ball? Spot of the ball. So it gives it on the 20. Hey, I'm just glad Connor put it out at the 5, Darrell, because if he had shanked that thing at the 20, they'd be at the 35. So either way, super job. Super job by Connor Thigpen.
That was a great kick.
Super kick.
Put it right where it needed to be. Quick quarterback sneak right up the middle.
Oh, man, trying to squeeze through there. We're hitting him with a shoulder, not locking up. We got to get the lock on that guy because if he gets one step in the backfield, nobody's going to catch him. Clock's ticking, minute 15 to go. Make him earn everything. Let's not let anybody get behind us. Number two's back at quarterback.
Hey, just kind of zone on one man. Here comes right up the middle.
Great job. Got the first down, but we don't care about first downs right now.
That'll stop the clock from moving the chains. But
do they have any timeouts left? Do we know?
We got one left.
Fultondale.
Maybe two. And the clock is going.
At front, seven guys need to make sure number 13 goes down. We got man-to-man out on the edges. He's rolling out to throw.
Like he's going to throw it.
And he may. Got him hemmed up. He's out of bounds. Stops the clock about the 35. Fultondale.
Everybody was covered up. He had nowhere to go with that ball.
Perfect defense. I tell you what, Coach Stafford's done a just super job with the defense tonight.
They were very well prepared.
40 seconds to go. We're doing a few substitutions.
Got four guys out here to the left. One
they
man
isolating
going,
him, and they're throwing it for him to get
throwing it. Throwing it deep, and he does catch it.
And he goes up and gets it above everybody. That's almost, they did it quick enough where you didn't realize what they were going to do. But they're all the way down to the ACA 25-yard line. When they start the clock, you're going to have 30 seconds to go.
They'd call a timeout, and they want to talk it over and get the right play called.
Right, and they give it him a rest because Adair Stewart is just absolutely gassed because he's done everything, everything for Fultondale tonight.
There's only been a few other people to touch the ball, but
they haven't done a whole lot, have they?
No, they haven't.
Well, good first half. Thought it would be a good game. Fultondale's a very, very good team. Top 10, 2A. Coming over here to ACA with Mr. Football, 2A football from last year. Adair Stewart, for the most part, probably kept him in check as well as he could. But here we go. We need to keep him out of that end zone with 30 seconds to go. Look for the quarterback draw here. I'm just linebackers. I just stay at home, make him throw it. Here he goes.
Oh!
Missed the tackle. He throws it away.
But that should be grounding in there.
Yeah, it is. Super play. Who is that? Big Harry Stokes?
Yeah, Big Harry Stokes. He got in there, hit him, wrapped him up.
Now, let me tell you. Let me tell you about Mr. Stokes. Great play, 6'2", 286. Harry weighs more than 286, I believe. And he came in and bear hugged Mr. Stewart and still couldn't bring him down. And he was about to tackle him, and Stewart just threw the ball away.
We do get super the intentional deep grounding. Loss of down.
Loss of down.
Loss super of about 15 yards. So,
and the main thing, loss of 7 seconds on that clock with a 15 yards.
Number two, back at quarterback.
All right. Got to have some help over the top. And
we need to see this and make an adjustment.
Yes. I don't even know why number 24 is even over here.
He needs to be over. I mean,
here he goes.
Look in one place, and there goes the ball.
And he falls down. We're just blessed tonight, Darrell, because
yes,
the play was there, and Adair Stewart fell down.
Yeah, if I was Fultondale, I'd line up in that same position again, look his way, and then throw it to the other side of the field.
Yeah, but that's so far tonight, they had depended on anybody else.
Just him. He's going back to quarterback on this play. 18.5 seconds left to go.
We got Grant Atkins. We have some injuries, so we've got a ninth grader in there, Grant Atkins, and he's playing center field. Ladarius throws it up. That's going to be pass interference because Mr. Atkins, or whoever that was, that's not Austin Atkins, is it? I don't know who that is. I can't see his number. His jersey's pulled down. But that's just 15 yards.
Chase Poland, number 28.
Hey, that's a good play based on the circumstances.
It is.
Because it's a penalty.
15 yards. It's not a spot foul. That'll get them back to their original line of scrimmage with 12 seconds left.
Exactly. Hey, you want to, is this situation, that's a great play. That's a great play. Now, 12 seconds, maybe two plays left.
They've got one timeout left.
Let's see if we can have some fortune here. Mr. Stewart is going to handle everything. He hands the ball off. And we're not tackling real well, but we finally get him down.
They called timeout.
They got their last timeout.
6.3 seconds.
I think they did that just to give number 13 a rest.
That or they're trying to get themselves into field goal position.
Well, they are.
Looks like their kicker, number 7, is coming out.
I saw him kicking earlier. Pretty decent kicker. So he is within their range for what he was kicking during warm-ups, but the real warm-ups is different than doing it.
Oh, it's a whole lot different. Got number 7, Enrique Aguilar.
Wow. Okay. I bet he can play some soccer, and I bet he can kick that football.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you this, if Mr. 13 is out there on this play, I believe I would keep my eye on
somebody
him.
On him.
I mean, for those that are listening, obviously you're watching, I'm telling you, this guy, he's done everything for Fultondale. I mean, just everything. So maybe he won't do anything in the next 6 seconds. We're about to find out.
Well, he's got his helmet in his hand. He's standing on the sideline.
That's
so
good for us.
That is very good for us. Number 8, Brandon Lewis, their holder.
He's in the center of the field.
Falls down, kicks up.
Good looking kick.
Good.
He got it. They score.
At the end of the first half, it'll be Patriots 13, Wildcats 10.
Great, great first half of football. Super half of football. Again, for those that are watching and listening, we're going to put the camera on the midfield. Fultondale band's here. Our band will be up. If I'm not mistaken, we got a little cheerleading going on at halftime. Dr. Carter just walked in the box. He gave me the thumbs up on that. So we're going to have a lot of picture taking and grandparents watching and that kind of thing. So we're going to leave it with you for a little while. We're going to leave it with you for a little while and let you watch the halftime festivities.
Ladies and gentlemen, to begin tonight's halftime presentation, we present our elementary cheerleaders and dance line. These girls participated in a clinic this week, and they want to demonstrate what they've learned for you tonight. Well, let's give these young ladies a round of applause.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Please join me in welcoming to the field the American Christian Academy Patriot Band. The band 2012 showcase entitled Commonwealth Patriot and includes a variety of patriotic music in different styles. Drum major Megan Spook, is your band ready? Ladies and gentlemen, the American Christian Academy Patriot Band. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for the American Christian Academy Patriot Band.
All right, Mr. Young, we back on track to start this game.
Ready to get the second half started. ACA with the lead, 13-10. Get the ball back to start the third quarter.
This is going to be a hard-fought game, it looks like. While we're waiting for the kickoff, I'm going to go around the region. Our region foes are all out of region. Fayette County's up at Sullivant. Gordo's up at Hamilton. Greensboro's over at Hale County. Billingsley's over at Holt, and Oakland, who's got a pretty good team, is up at Northside. So that might be a pretty good game. And Sipsey Valley is at Curry tonight. So that's what's going on around the region. Big region game next week. Gordo coming into town. Good team, good coaching, good players, good tradition. As we get ready to start this second half. We've got Mr. Stewart going out to midfield, meeting Sean Blackburn. Patriots going to receive the kickoff. I wonder if we got any scores. Rail, you heard any scores so far?
Hamilton is up on Gordo, 7-0. Can't really tell what quarter they're in.
Sometimes the internet don't give you all the information you want to know. But I can tell you about this game. If we can score on this first possession, this will go a long way to help us win this game. However, if we don't score on this first possession and they score and get the momentum, the Patriots are going to have their hands full. So, we're about to see how that all unfolds as the Fultondale Wildcats, now up north of Birmingham, not too north, almost in Birmingham, get ready to kick the ball to us. So we shall see shortly.
John Roberts still back deep.
Caleb Squires, J.D. Heiss. See who gets it. It looks like it's going to be John Roberts. No.
Caleb Squires takes the ball. Brought down at the 35-yard line.
Not a bad start. We'll see what happens.
That Austin Hallman in crutches down the sideline.
That is not a good thing. It looks like a knee is what it looks like.
Yep. I do not see Parker Dare.
Well, I heard at halftime down below that he may have some real issues. That is not good for next week.
No, it's not.
Two key starters, not good. But as part of the game, football is a lot like life. You don't know what's coming down the pike. You got to be ready.
Yep.
Austin Mullenbrock. In the shotgun, Austin Aiken behind him.
John Roberts up to the top, one-on-one coverage, swing pass, in and out of his hands.
Guys, it's just a matter of quickness and speed. By the time that play develops, number one is on Austin, and there's nowhere to go.
J.T. Heiss had the ball in his hands. I think he looked up before.
Or J.T. Heiss, you're right. We're going to run a little bit before he had the ball, wasn't he, Durrell?
Had heard them footsteps coming.
Okay, second and 10. John Roberts isolated over here. We've got Trips over to the right. Got an option
play. Missed a block.
Missed a block and nowhere to go. And I'll share you something. Logan Elliott comes out and just couldn't get there, but just found out from his dad at halftime, number 64, one of our best linemen, is playing with the flu tonight. So he's just doing the best he can. And I tell you what, with injuries and the flu and being shorthanded, we're not very deep to start with. We're battling, though. That makes us better all the way up and down. Last-minute substitution. Play clock's already down to 15. We're still in the huddle. I hope we know what we're going to do pretty quickly. Don't want to waste the time out here. 7-6. Looks like we're going to get it off.
Just do. Oh, anyhow, it's a little bit low for
a little
John
bit low at his feet. Not looking real sharp offensively. Going to have to punt the ball. That's not what we wanted to do to start off with. We need Connor Thigpen to get one of his booming punts, which you got to take a little off to get it out of Adair Stewart's hands. So we'll see if he gets as good as he did last time. Got a lot of room out to the right side.
So tell you, I would not kick it to him.
Not a very
low
good snap.
And
he kicks it this way, which is kind of surprising, but out of bounds, they're going to get a heck of a spot.
Spotting it at the 43.
I like the spot. I don't know how he got that spot.
That's a very generous spot on the part of ACA because that ball did not go out at the 43-yard line.
Usually, folks, as you see on TV, you're supposed to walk up the line to see where the angle goes out. Referee on this side of the ball, one of the coaches made it a fair catch over about 5 yards out of bounds, and he marks it in the field right there.
It looks good. Let's spot it here.
We'll take it. It gives them an extra 10 yards or more to go. So
our Darius back up under center.
And he is going to hand it
off.
Hands it off
to number 12, and there is nobody home.
He's gone.
That is six for the other team. Now, I don't know where our linebackers were, but we did not have a middle linebacker there to stop that play. And that was just a simple dive right up the middle, and he's in the end zone for six. So just like that, we are down 16-13.
Not how we wanted to start. Need to fight back. Still a close game. PAT coming up, Fultondale. There's a snap. Doesn't look like he made it. He did. He squeezed it in. It was not a good snap. Holder did a good job. So it's 17-13, Fultondale.
Number 12, Kyrie Robinson with a 57-yard dive play right up the middle, takes it in for six.
Not sure he was touched. Not sure he was even touched. Well, we go from being on top within about a minute and a half, less than 2 minutes. We're We're down four, but still in the game. We're going to try to bounce back. Fultondale got a little more pump in their step, which they should. John Roberts again back in the middle. J.T. Hodge.
Caleb Squire.
Looks like Enrique is lining up to kick it short again.
John Roberts looks like he's going to take it. Getting upfield.
Had a couple of good blocks. If we would have held on to those blocks just a little bit longer, I think he could have moved that ball down the field a little bit more. But not a bad place to put the ball.
Almost the same spot we had last time, a little better. 37. Yard line. Here comes the ACA Patriots. Really need to make something happen here.
At the 25-yard line. 13-yard
gain on return.
First down.
American
first down.
Got the eye backfield. J.T. Hodge fullback. Austin Akers tailback. Bunker block up under center. We got a bunch of people up in that line. We sweep it to the right. Speed is just not going to get us there.
Nope. They just had it strung out too far. Might have gained half a yard, but
Fultondale,
not much.
Very
there.
Fast as a team. Hard to go laterally.
As many folks as they've got in the box, we've got to push it down the field. Put the ball in the air. And
going to have to throw it, looks like.
Make them defend us.
Very athletic. Eight men in the box. We still have he's in the gun. Here we go. Going to run it again.
We saw a
Austin
little
turns
team.
It up, did a little better. We got about a third and four to go, third and five. I'll tell you, the Fultondale bunch will bring it to you now. They're hitting hard.
Number 22 for Fultondale, Julian Hardy, lost his helmet. Had a little bit of things to say about it after the play.
Uh-oh. Big third down, third and five. We really don't need to go three and out again. Coach Smelly sends in the play. Austin Mullenbrock's under center. Got John Roberts out to the right. Not surprised we don't go out there, but we're going to fake it. Go back.
And
great play.
That was a great play. Oh, he should have just run hard.
Great play.
That
Aaron
was
Bob.
A great play call.
All the way down.
Hit the tight end on a little short fly pattern right down the middle of the field.
I'm going to tell you, it seems to me, Darrell, that great play calling because Coach Smelly set that play up by running that sweep to the other way.
Yeah, I've noticed that they haven't had anybody on the tight end all night long.
Now, he was
same
right
thing out. When Aaron scored that touchdown.
Darrell, it's been about 30 years since I played ball, and I think I could even quickly lead that pass. He was so old.
He was just standing by himself.
Well, ACA in business at the 29-yard line of Fultondale. First down. Mullenbrock under center. He's rolling out to his right. He's pitching it.
Options.
Speed is tough to beat out there. Austin Aiken fights for about 3 yards, four maybe.
He just didn't have a whole lot of room left once he got that football.
No. I'm telling you, I keep saying it, but they are just athletic. On the line, linebackers, defensive backs. I see why they're ranked in 2A. Second and seven. Need to score big time here. They got John Roberts out here. We're running Austin Akins up.
He found a hole.
He found a hole. Did good.
Tell you, Austin hits those holes quick.
Got two against Fultondale because they closed quick. And they got a few yards. It's going to be third and about one, a long one maybe. Need a first down here to keep this drive going, get back in this game.
Third and a short two inside the 21.
See Mike Rada down on the sidelines from ABC 33-40. I would like for him to see a touchdown by the Patriots right now. It would be awesome.
That would be a good thing for them to catch for their highlight reel tonight.
Let's look at the play clock. 10 down to 10. We're still talking in the backfield. We don't want to use a timeout. Call it. There we go. No. Not sure about that.
I don't think he got there. Oh, we got a flag on the play.
And that's either on 72 or for them or 42 for us. And that's going to hurt us because we'll have about fourth and a half yard.
Personal foul against
us. Oh,
no. It's going to be offsetting penalties against both teams.
That's good.
Had a little bit too much extracurricular activity going on in the backfield after the play was over.
Does that mean we replay the down, hopefully?
No, it was dead ball after
dead
the
ball.
Play.
So we're going to have fourth and still. Did he get any yardage there?
Yeah, we did. It should be fourth and half a yard at the 30-yard line.
I tell you what, I would I'm not sure I'd try to outrun these guys. Big Nelson Brown pushed about 4 or 5 yards a while ago right up the middle.
Looks like we are going to go for it on fourth and a yard.
Well, a field goal would be pretty far out, even for Connor, with 7 minutes to go. We're only down four.
It would be
Coach
about
Smelly's showing a lot of confidence in his offense. We're going to see what we can do here. They're working up in the box big time.
And we
got the first
got
down. Great play.
That was a good hole for Austin Aiken to run through, and he picked up four.
Good
maybe
play.
Five.
Still in business, Darrell. We're marching, doing a good job. This will really help us confidence-wise. We can put this in.
Tell you, running behind the big boys over there on the side, Austin Aiken and Logan Elliott. Number 54, William Sullivan, just pushed the pile.
First down, ACA. Fultondale 16-yard line. John Roberts coming out to the left. J.D. Heights in the slot. Somebody does not see something they like. Coach calls timeout. We're going to make sure we're on track because we really need this score at
we
this
do.
Point in the game.
We need to put it in the end zone here. 6 minutes, 16 left to go in the third quarter.
Well, we hope everybody enjoyed the halftime show. Two bands, a bunch of cheerleaders tonight. Matter of fact, my neighbor has a little girl that was cheerleading tonight. We were talking to her at halftime. Randy McGew from up around Haleyville lives next door to me. His daughter Reagan. They just had a good time this week working with the varsity cheerleaders and learning to be cheerleaders.
And they did a really good job.
Did you see all the grandparents and parents with those cameras?
You could not find a square inch on that fence line.
I'm talking about from 30 to 30 or more.
They were lined up all the way down, cameras flashing, video cameras going.
Well, we're about to see if the ACA Patriots can punch it in. We've got J.D. Heights in the slot out to the left. John Roberts on the left. Got number 9 Newman Bailey up top. Box is the tight end, kind of flexed. Looks like we might be chunking that thing this time. And we are.
He's got time. He's
perfect
got a man.
Throw.
Oh,
a little high.
In and out
in
of
and
the
out
hand.
Of John Roberts' hand. Time to jump great. Hit him right in the hands. It was a little high. It was there.
That was one we should have caught.
Oh, that was a missed opportunity for sure. Thought John might be able to pull that down. He had a lot of separation from his defender. Really no free safety, so Austin could have thrown it a little bit lower and further out, but just didn't happen that way. So second down, 10. See what we got here. Same formation, same personnel. We're going to chunk it again. Fake it going out
going
to him
the
again.
Corner.
Gets him in the hands again, and he couldn't get it. Just out. That was a little tougher than the first one. we're just kind of commit to throwing the ball. I don't think we're going to try to run down there. Of course, the field is shorter, and they've got 8 men in the box.
I mean, they're not bad play calls. Both of those balls could have been caught, could have been a touchdown. No, we just got to finish the play.
That would have been a super catch. John Roberts had gotten that second. First one was a little bit better. But here we go again. And I'm sure if we don't get this one, we'll kind of thick pin or try to get us within one. Two in the backfield. He's isolated John again over here. So here we go.
Looks like he's looking his way.
He needs to throw the ball.
Brought down in the backfield.
Brought
down that around the 19-yard line.
Missing some blocks, but thought he was going to pull the trigger there, but I couldn't see downfield from my viewpoint. But Connor Thigpen's on. We're going to try to close this thing to a one-point game. This is how long is it field goal there, Darrell?
The field goal will be 36 yards.
Connor's got the leg. We just want a good snap, a good hold, and we'll have a good shot at it. Here comes the snap. Good snap, good hold, good kick.
He's up,
his
and it is good.
Good distance.
Right down the middle.
It is good. I'm going to tell you, Mr. Thigpen proves us every week.
He is
got
a
the
weapon
leg.
That we can definitely count on, that's for sure. See, if he gets a good hold, good snap, good hold, he is – I haven't seen him miss one.
Pretty much automatic. Well, folks, 5:19 to go in the third, 17-16 ball game. I thought this would have the makings to be a good game.
And it is indeed. It is a battle. You know, if we can just keep our concentration on defense, make those tackles, wrap up when we have to, you know, wrap up on that first contact, bring them down right there instead of letting them get the yards after the first contact, we'll be doing a whole lot better. We have the ability to shut them down from this point forward. I don't know that they have the ability to stop us moving the ball.
Tell you what, we don't make any mistakes or allow big plays. That's asking a lot, especially with Mr. Stewart on the other side. But I think we win this game, that being the case. He kicks it right down in the hole where Mr. Stewart can't get to it. Got a tackle, missed one tackle, and got the next one. Got a little extracurricular field going on out there. Can't tell who's initiating that, but there's a lot of after-the-play stuff happening. They're getting the ball on the 25, 26-yard line. Let's see if we can't get a stop here. We got a number two at quarterback. Where is he?
Odds are he's going to hand us number 13 out of the backfield.
And he did, and he gets about six, but he doesn't break it. Second and five from about the 31-yard line. The ACA defense, pretty much bend but don't break attitude, done a great job, great game plan. You hold Fultondale to 10 points.
Darius back at quarterback.
Yep, they swap him around all over the place. Hand off. Give him the ball. There's nothing there. We've got him. We've got to hold on to him. For some reason, we want to tackle high and not grab the feet. But still a good play.
Bring up third and about four. Four.
He didn't get much, did he? Maybe 1-2 yards. Yeah, about two.
Yep, not much to it.
Big play here. As we've said many times and probably say the rest of the game, got to watch number 13 because he's the one probably going to go try to get this first down.
I would look for a quarterback draw on this play.
Just had a whistle over there. Did they call? I don't see a signal of a timeout. Referee umpire talking. Umpire on the Fultondale side. A referee on the Fultondale sideline, Judge. I don't see what happened.
They're having a discussion. Might be a sideline warning. I don't know. I don't see a flag on the field.
Here comes the referee. If Folks, we're trying to find out what's going on here. We just kind of had a little break in the action. Referee, line judge are over at the Fultondale side talking to their coach. If Fultondale had any momentum, hopefully this will take a little edge off maybe. Well, this quarter's getting past us. 4 minutes to go. Probably got a little timeout up here. We got a.
I think they're talking about the spot of the ball.
Maybe so. Very talented group up here in the booth. Cole Finley's now on the computer and John Gabber's on the camera. These guys are versatile up here. I'm telling you what, doing a great job. Appreciate them helping out. Here we go, back to action. Third and about four. Here we go. We're thinking he's going to throw that ball downfield, but you got to watch him.
He does.
He catches that ball for a first down.
Low pass, but it was right where his man could catch it.
Our cameraman said he didn't catch the ball, but he didn't count what Brother John Galvis says. Counts what that referee says, John. Sorry, buddy. It's first down, Fultondale. Here we go. Trips to this side. He usually rolls this way if he does, or throws it back to number two, isolated. Guy in the slot back there.
And quarterback draw.
Great tackle by Aaron Box.
It was. He was getting blocked in the back down the field and still makes the tackle.
He gets 5 yards, but I'm going to tell you, that's how you tackle somebody like the number 13, Mr. Stewart, is hit him on the legs and grab hold. Can't run without the legs. I don't care who you are.
That's right. You take your legs out, you can't go anymore.
3 minutes to go, third quarter. Fultondale at their 45-yard line. They're on 45. Twins each side. Number 12 in the backfield. Looks like Mr. Stewart's going to take it in the shotgun this time. And he's going to run that time.
Run it right up the middle.
We're hitting him high, not grabbing him. We're not going to bring him down like that. Flag at the end of the play. Don't know what that is. He just got a first down.
The way Fultondale's reacting, I think he got a face mask.
We'll see shortly. That's exactly what it is, Darrell. You got that call. That's going to hurt. But
I think it's just a 5-yard variety, though, so it won't be
too bad.
As bad as it could have been.
That'll at least keep the big plays from happening. We've not had many, and I'm going to tell you that's very good for our defense. Nelson Brown comes in. Logan Elliott comes out. Logan's fighting the flu, so he's playing his backside off tonight, trying to slow down this Fultondale deal. He's got two in the backfield, which are very rare.
Hand off to number nine.
He's loose. He's still loose. He's still loose.
Forced out about the four.
I'm probably guessing about 4 or 5 tackles he goes through. We had him at the line of scrimmage. He bounces off, pulls out of a little arm tackle, and then goes down the sideline, and it's first and goal on about the 3.
We need to do some tackle practice.
We're going to have our hands full here. Hopefully we can get maybe a turnover. We take that right now. Number 2's back up under center, so you know number 13's going
to
get the ball, I would think.
He's going to hand it right
there. And there he goes. And he goes, and he struggles. And
second effort gets him down to about the 6-inch yard.
Good play on the defense, though. Held him in there, but he is just short of the goal line.
Second and 6 inches to go.
2 minutes to go, third quarter. Fultondale's knocking at the door. Patriots need to keep their heads up, playing a great ball game. Looks like could be the same play the way they're setting up again. 2 is under center, and that's exactly what they do. And I tell you, they got him stood up, but he does make it in.
They didn't stand him up, but he didn't have far to go.
No, that's true, about a half a yard. So Fultondale adds to their 1-point lead, 23-16, going to attempt the PAT.
Mr. Enrique Aguilar back for a kick.
And looks pretty good. So, 24-16. Minute 42 to go. One score lead. So ACA still very much in the ball game.
That is very true. We are not out of it. They're playing good. We've had some injuries to some key people that have hurt us. Have our center go down, one of our best receivers and defensive backs go down. And
tough situation. It makes you a better football team, and they're responding pretty well right now.
We've got some guys that are pushing through after being sick.
I tell you what, though, too, Drell, with the teams we've got left on the schedule, they're going to be a lot like this team right here, especially Fayette County. They'll have this kind of team. Gordo, probably. So this hopefully will make us a little better team as we go down and hopefully get one or two of our players back here in week two. All right, let's see here. Fultondale about to kick off. We got Cole Campbell back, but they shank it over to the side.
Let that one go.
It's not going out of bounds.
Not going out of bounds. Picked up by number 25, JT Heights.
He's still on his feet.
He gets out to the 36.
He's still on his feet, and they blow it.
They blew him dead. He doesn't think his knee went down.
No.
He's still running.
All right. ACA at their own 36-yard line. We need to make something happen here.
1:34 left to go in the third. It'd be nice to get a score on the board before this quarter ends.
You're not kidding. But I tell you what, if we can score it this quarter, next quarter, before they do, it'll just give us a lot of confidence to still fight in this game. That's what we need to do. They have got a bunch of guys in that box. Not a good snap, a little hesitant, and he's
not much blocking.
Tremendously. Number 22 doing a little celebrating, but the referee's not going to do anything about it, so we lose about four. Bad snap kept us from getting to the line of scrimmage, and Fultondale, as they have all night, been very quick to the ball. Fox already started down to 18. We don't have a play call. We just got it in there. We're going to have to get to the line of scrimmage pretty quick. Hopefully we don't have to burn a timeout right here, but this.
We got about 10 seconds to get it off. They're all hustling to the line, so I think
close.
We'll be all right.
I hope we don't make too rushed decision here. Here we go. He's looking. Oh, great. Great recovery. Nowhere to go. Austin comes down, goes back across the field, and finds Newman Bailey. Instead of having a no gain, we get
pick up seven.
Seven, so it's third and seven, and we got a shot.
It could be the last play. It will be. That'll be the last play of the third quarter.
Third quarter went pretty quick.
Well, now they may try to get it off.
Yeah, we're going to try to do it. I don't know why the whistle blew. I do not know why the whistle blew.
Looks like it.
I'm not sure.
I don't know why we would have called a timeout.
I'm not sure why we would call a timeout, and we could have let the clock run out and go to the fourth quarter.
Would have been no penalty.
Right.
That doesn't make a whole lot of sense.
No, I'm not sure, unless they were afraid we were going to make a bad mistake right there, which may be the case, but still. Timeout. I hope we don't need down the road. Three seconds to go in the third quarter.
Yeah, I bet the coach is going to be wishing we would have had that one still in our pocket sometime in the fourth quarter.
Maybe Mike Rader taking off, going back to Birmingham.
Very well could be.
I wish he could have seen us score. Anyway, back into action, third and seven. 3 seconds to go in the third quarter. This play will end the third quarter. And hopefully we'll have a first down going into the fourth. Bullen brought back, throws out a screen pass. Nowhere to go. Nowhere to go.
Blocking just stopped dead right in front of him. They sure got to be pushing down the field.
No blocks gotten on the play. Didn't have a chance to develop. Tough situation for Mr. Box when he got the ball. So fourth and eight means that we're going to be punting the ball. Momentum so far is the Fultondale. They have an 8-point lead. But we'll see. That's why we play the game. You don't know what's going to happen. You need to dial up a fumble for them, a recovery for us, a big play on defense, big play on offense, and get back in this game. Pretty good crowd here at ACA. A lot of folks on the deck. We've got a fairly good crowd for Fultondale. We like to play that music loud here at ACA during halftime and before the game. Get my age, I kind of wish we'd tone it down a little bit. But anyway, starting of the fourth quarter, 24-16. ACA will punt, fourth and eight. Connor Thigpen gets off, pretty good punt. He's kicking it out of bounds. It looks like it goes right out at the 38-yard line. So Fultondale will have the ball first and 10 on their 38. Really need a stop here. Really need a stop. Going to be very, very tough for ACA to get back in this thing if we let them score again. Trips out to the left. Single man up to the right. Stewart's in the shotgun, and here he goes. Draw play. Gets about 4 yards. Second and four, Fultondale. One of the few times that Mr. Stewart doesn't throw it or run it himself. Fultondale comes up the line. Stewart again in the shotgun. Got an overload to the right.
They're going that way.
And that's where they roll. And he almost breaks through the whole thing. Well, first down, Fultondale. I tell you what, if he keeps his balance there,
he would have been gone.
We're in trouble. Again. Running up in there, some of our guys are running up there with a shoulder instead of grabbing those legs. Got to get the legs to somebody like that. First down, ACA 46. Fultondale in the shotgun. Hands it off
showing
to number,
back
hands
out.
Off number nine. He's going through us. Broke about four tackles. Mr. Samuel Brown, senior, 6'1", 177.
Brought down by number 28, Chase Bolin, number three.
Second one. Need to stop here, Durrell. Need to stop bad.
Yes, we do. I'm expecting a quarterback draw.
Speed sweep to the there right. Number 11 goes. And,
right around the end, picks up four.
He kind of stumbles, gets the first down.
He is quick coming over.
I'm telling you, I like the speed, number two. Christopher Lewis, number 11. Jared Stewart, he's a ninth grader. I wonder if that's little brother to Darius. I don't know, but he's got the speed, too, so if it runs in the family, it sure is showing.
Yep.
Good-looking kid. Good-looking ninth grader. We're starting a little early there. They didn't call it. He bust through there. Number 12, the same play they scored on before.
Yep. Nobody home for Kyrie Robinson.
Well, and he started early, and they didn't call it. He started a step before they centered the ball, but that's not gonna matter. Go up to a two-score game. That was pretty obvious to me, but I'm for ACA too, so. Kicks the ball. He gets the score. 31-16.
9:36 to go in the fourth.
Right.
Okay, we need a couple of quick scores to get us back in this ball game.
Well, got our work cut out for us here week five with the Fultondale Wildcats leading by two scores. Need something good to happen. Something good to happen. Back for ACA, number 27, Cole Campbell. Number 25, JT Heights. And number 4, Caleb Squires.
Looks like he's lining up for another one of those short kicks.
Mr. Aguilar is going to see what he can do with that pigskin here. Backed off about 3 yards. That orange shoe. And he puts it on the ground. I'm not sure why number 5 didn't try to run a little bit there.
Yeah, but he had 10 yards out in front of Joshua Gillian.
He got him about at least 5 or 10 more yards, but he just wanted to make sure that he didn't bump the ball, I guess. So he's got a set up here at 36-yard line. We got time. 9:31. But we better make
use
progress.
Of it.
Got trips out to the right. Twins up top in the shotgun. Looks like we're about to ready to throw that ball. He throws his flag. Somebody.
Too many on the field.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Just when we need the stump to start going, it puts us in the hole.
It's going the wrong way.
Well, first and 15. So we've got to go 15 yards. A little different set. Twins up top. 21. He gets around him.
He's got some room.
He goes to midfield. Does a great job.
That was a good pass, a good play, a good run by number 20.
Charlie Thigpen, ninth grader. All 150 pounds of him, a man. Eluded the tackle, got upfield. Great looking play. That'll help. We need some people to take a little load off John Roberts because he gets all the attention.
Yep. And he was on that team. That play, he was double teamed, and Charlie was just standing there by himself.
First down at midfield. ACA's got a little something going on. Hope we can keep it happening. Plenty of time. He sees him across the corner. Throws it up too high. Overthrows
high
it. And
they bring it back to the 50.
He was open, too. He was wide open.
He was.
Had plenty of protections. The play was a great call by Coach Smelly. Had enough time for the guy to drag across the field. Probably would have been a first down. And just overthrew it. And number one for Fultondale, Mr. Tinsley, was just happened to be at the right place at the right time.
And up number 9, gain of 5.
to coming off the ball.
Samuel Brown.
A little bit, so pushing us a little. We're tired. Some of our guys are sick. Nelson Brown's playing the whole game. Tough situation.
Yeah, and you throw an interception like that, and they could really get some of these guys discouraged.
Well, we need something good to happen right here. They got trips up top to the right. Twins down low to the left. Mr. Stewart's alone in the backfield. So let's see if we can't get something good to happen to us. He's going to do a quarterback draw. He's out in space. And
yeah,
he is gone.
They got a holding play this time. I mean, they called it. That was one of the few that they've seen. But he did see it. I mean, that was one that was just too hard to miss.
And he saw it at the right time Mr. Stewart hit a crease. And that speed we were talking about that not many young men have, we just saw it. He was gone. Fultondale fans not real happy about it. Don't know why, but pretty obvious a hole. But when you're on rooting for another team, as the old song from John Conley says, you see things through rose-colored glasses and not see exactly like somebody else sees it in the other team. So they'll be backed up, have a little more work to do, give us another shot.
Right about second and 14 to go.
That six would have just about done us in, but we still have some life, Darrell. Still have some life.
We've got a little bit of time left. We've just got to shut them down here on defense.
Second and 13. 47-yard line of Fultondale.
Got
a speed sweep going.
It to him. Oh, big Logan Ellis.
Big
he
Logan
just had
him, and we still got him for no gain.
Yeah, it was no gain. I tell you, if he had half a step more quickness, he could have brought him down.
He
the
sure
back
had.
End.
I tell you what, if number 64 had not had the flu tonight, he probably would have made that play. He just giving it all he's got.
He is indeed.
Third down, 13. Big play. This is huge. Just we can hold them here, make them punt. This puts us back in the game. We have a shot at this thing. With 7:25 left. Here we go. Trips to the left. Single man out to the right. Mr. Stewart. And we're showing blitz.
He could have called a false start there, but
yeah,
they didn't
do it. He didn't do it. He is
man
slinging
on
it.
Man. He got Charlie back there.
Charlie got to turn around and go call a flag. Because you got to turn around to find the thing. Number two is talking to him. You should flag him for his taunting, but he's not.
I think that referee was just a little bit too far out of position. You know, he sees him running with him step for step. You know, Charlie has the right to be where he was.
No
he
doubt.
He
had good position. What he didn't do, and what a lot of times they'll call, is that when the ball's in the air and the defensive man's got to turn and find the ball. If he would have done that, then I don't think he would have thrown the flag. But he did, and it's first automatic first down, which is really going to be tough for the ACA Patriots now.
First and 10, 38.
We have them on the ropes to get that ball back and just let them get back in the game. Number two under center now.
And number 13 is going to get
means.
That ball.
And he gets it. And
not
good
much.
Defense. Not much at all. Maybe a couple. The tough thing about this is the fact that the clock is running. And it's under 7 minutes. That's not good for us either, especially when you're behind. Number 64 comes off just absolutely exhausted, trying to get some fluid in him and rest. Just a little while. I'll bet he'll be back pretty soon. He's letting that time. They're milking the clock.
All that he can off of it. Just a simple handoff right up the middle. Fultondale's content to let that clock run out.
They sure are, Darrell, and they're making that known. Because it's just now 3rd and 7. They're probably going to go for it on 4th. And that clock is down, just going under 6 minutes. Big Harry Stokes comes in the game to give Nelson Brown a little bit of a break.
And
They're going to let it run all the way down to zero and then call a timeout, looks like. And that's what they did. Fultondale uses their first timeout.
Well, that proves that they're looking that clock down because they know it'll be hard for us to score twice less than 5 minutes to go. So we're going to give it our best shot. We sure don't need them to get a first down, that's for sure. Pretty good turnout tonight. Non-region play, week five. Next week, we got Gordo here. If you're planning on coming to the ACA game, you better get here early because I'll bet you the Green Wave fills up the whole side over there, so we need all our fans out rooting on the Patriots. Hopefully we can get some of these injured folks back. Also, before we get started, remember, if you're listening to us, please call 205-553-5963, extension 27, and let us know who you are and who you're listening and where you're listening from. All right, here we go. Fultondale trips to the left, Twins right. Mr. Stewart's going to run that ball. And he gets the first down. I'm not so sure if I were them, I'd run that play about 50% of the time because that's tough to do.
Well, you know, they're missing the holding calls up there, but even so, he is a tough guy to bring down.
All right, 5:20 to go. Getting tougher and tougher for ACA to get back in this thing. Fultondale's got the ball, 2-score lead, first down on ACA's 21. Man, I wish.
Hand it off to number 9, Samuel Brown. He picks up 5.
I was hoping we had number 9 stood up and somebody take that ball from him. That's what we need to happen right now.
Yeah, we can't score without the ball. Got to get it somehow, some way. Preferably we get it back without them putting it in the end zone.
Number 86 into the game. Joe Pickering, we've been kind of impressed with him. He's a newcomer with his play. So he's going to get a little action and get some. Fultondale Wildcat. He's got the range on that defensive end. He might be able to more deal with Mr. Stewart. They're coming the other way. Number 12 has just gone through about 2 or 3 more tackles.
Kyrie Robinson, he's gotten quite a few carries today.
He sure has. 2 scores and both of them pretty long, I believe. But Mr. Robinson, junior, 5'8", 145, and he runs every bit of 145 when he runs. First and goal for the Fultondale Wildcats on the ACA 8-yard line, or 7 maybe. Need to really keep him out of there. We're going to have a horse collar tackle, which is going to give them another first down, half distance to go, so that's not going to help us. Just a few little things not going our way, Darrell's not helping.
No, that was one that we could have avoided. We had him. Didn't need the horse collar tackle, but we did, so they're going to have the ball around the 3-yard line.
Harry Stokes coming out. Getting a little bit of a rest. Number 60, replacing him, Mr. Allison, 6'1", 260, getting a little bit of meat up in there, trying to keep him out of the end zone. They're letting that clock roll. Down to 3:30 to go in the game. Tough situation for the Patriots, in a hole, trying to dig out. Still playing hard, still playing well. Number 9 gets the ball, goes in for the score. Tough situation. That's just about going to do it for the Patriots. You know, you go back and look at several things that could have been turned around here. They got a lot of athletes derailed, but the interception really hurt us.
It did indeed.
Because you had a, you basically at that time had a one-score game, and had a first down on our own 35-yard line would have made a big, big difference. But hey, it doesn't happen, and that's the way it goes. And ACA is going to have to just finish out, play hard, watch some film, learn from the game, and get ready for a big, big region game next week, because we can pull it off against the Gordo Green Wave here next Friday. Then we will be a heavy favorite to finish second in our region. But still a lot of football to go. You don't know who's going to get injured. You don't know who's going to show up.
Hopefully Austin Holman's not too bad, and he'll be able to come back. Parker, I'm pretty sure that Logan will get better by next week.
Yep.
It is tough when you lose some of the key players.
Got to shake it off. Fultondale getting ready to kick. Mr. Aguilar with his orange shoe. They say he's playing like he's going to squib it, and he does. And we take it like a grounder and get it on about a 32. So, here we go, ACA. Let's fight to the end, guys, and see if we can't score. Get some more points on the board here with 3:16 to go. We almost had 12 on the field again.
Yeah, number 33, Brady Kale coming off.
I assume we're going to chunk it. Mr. Stewart's back about 25 or 30 yards, so they're not going to let us get the home run.
Charlie
number
Thigpen's
21, Charlie Thigpen's got it again.
Picks up the first down. Stops the clock for a second.
Twins top. John Roberts down here by himself. A little help over the top from Mr. Stewart. They're blitzing. Going to have to get rid of it. And we do. Incomplete pass. So it will be
not enough time to get rid of the ball to where he wanted it to go.
Not at all. I'm not sure it was going to be a kind of a screen or just he was rushed. I don't know.
There wasn't a whole lot of slowing those guys down on that one. Yeah, we've had some pass plays where he's had all the time in the world.
No doubt.
But that was not one of them.
I think on his interception he had several more.
Like here he goes. He's got lots of time here.
A great recovery.
Incomplete.
Aaron Box drops the ball. Looks like he was going to go down the field with Charlie Thigpen, but he didn't pull the trigger. Almost got tackled. Tried to get Aaron Box. Aaron didn't look like he was expecting it. Went through his hand. 3rd and 10. 2:43 to go. Got to have 10 yards. Here we go. Mullenbrock got to throw it. He does. Almost a great catch by number 9.
Newman Bailey almost grabbed one on the back of his back shoulder. Mullenbrock was hit right after he throws the ball.
It's 4th down. Got to go for it.
Nothing to lose.
Nothing to
lose. 2:33 left to go in the 4th quarter, down by 3 scores. And
we'll see what happens. We need to give Austin a little bit of time, and then he needs to pull that trigger. Because it's do or die right now for a first down. Let's see if we can't get the first down and go on to score before this game's over with. Here's a snap. The throw's kind of behind him. John Roberts could not get back to it. It would have been a super catch if he'd have been able to do it, but he wasn't able to get back to it. He threw the ball behind him, nowhere to go. Fultondale takes over. Will probably do it for ACA. 2:28 to go. Ball on ACA's 44-yard line. Von Spick Fultondale will run the clock out. And this will be in the books. Anyway, looks like there's a little confusion on our defense. We've got a few new folks in there. We're shifting all around. So hands off to number 9. He gets about 3. To ACA's 40. It'll be second down.
ACA began to put in a few of the younger players, give them some playing time.
All right. Second and about 7.
So number 8, Trey Chapman pushing in.
Hand off, same play. Number 9, he breaks through.
You know, and
oh, gracious.
We don't need to give him another touchdown. You know, they're not throwing the ball. I don't think they're trying to run up the score, but we're not doing much to stop them.
Logan Elliott's coming out again. He needs to stay out and try to get home and get well. Tough game for the ACA Patriots. Down to about a minute 25 to go. First down. Letting the clock go down. Mr. Stewart's getting everybody still so he get the ball. He's going to take a kneel. Kneel down. That was just about maybe a play or two, and it'll be over. Well, we appreciate you listening tonight. As Fultondale runs out the clock, we appreciate John Galbraith and Cole Finley in here doing the job for us. They did a wonderful job, guys.
Did a great job tonight.
We miss Coach Crow, but I'm sure he'll be back for the Gordo game. Fox down to 36, 35 seconds. Kneel down.
I think that's going to be the last
snap
of the night. They'll let the clock go down a little bit before they wind the play clock.
Yep, that'll do it.
That'll
right
be it.
Well,
it was a good battle in the first half. We just let it get away from us there in the second.
Sure did. They got, like I said, they had a lot of athletes as they get ready to shake hands at midfield. We'll tell you again, if you're listening, please call 205-553-5963, extension 27. Tell us who you are and where you're listening from. Next Friday night, Gordo Green Wave. Look forward to y'all tuning in and coming out to the game then. So we're going to sign off and talk to you next week. Thanks for listening. ACA Patriots.
Thank you. Thank you.